mind. And it makes the rules, it sets the fines, and you pay them every time with your dread. Do you find out why the crackle stings? Is it love or fear? Puffing up your chest, but you have to be the best, or fold your hands. Did you go with a backup plan? Alone. It's not too late. That's what the crackle says. Welcome to Wednesday night live at Binions. This is our singer-songwriter night. It's all about us playing all of the original music that we never get to play in other places, and our special guests who bring some cool new vibes. So what you'll hear tonight from us will be all original. And this is a song we wrote.
Unless we decide to do it, not
we may do some other stuff.
Every once in a while, we'll do some Bill Biv DeVoe.
Okay, all right, whatever. I'm up for it. So this is a song we wrote a couple of years back. Everybody's talking about the Taliban. You said it was something hard to understand. You said we haven't seen it since the rise of man. You made a God in the image of a man. You made a God. Everybody's talking about Afghanistan, like women only suffer in a foreign land. As if patriarchy wasn't all American. With a God in the image of a man. With a God of a man. Ignorance is not bliss. Just taking everything we think for granted. And arrogance is a defense. get. What you get is what you see. The rest is all just a mystery. Everybody's talking about the Taliban. You can see the same thing in almost every land. A prophet's words get twisted to a politician's plan. And a God in the image of a man. And a God in the image of a man. But vengeful God, we love to sanctify our triggers. Well, maybe we should fire that God and find a God that's bigger. Ignorance is not bliss. Just taking everything we think for granted. And arrogance is a defense. Your fears from running rampant. And what you see is what you get. What you get is what you see. And the rest is all just a mystery.
I think we're gonna get our friend up, Tyrel Choat, gonna play y'all some music. So Tyrel is also in the Apogeos, and could actually be in any band in the United States because he's the most killer ripping guitar player.
So, are we gonna
hang
the guitar?
Yeah.
You wanna sit down?
Yeah, probably. That's probably good. So just plug this in, it will automatically go.
Okay. You want to use my stool?
Sure.
Yeah. Let's take you up there.
Can I make an announcement?
Yes. Yes.
Do I need the brown
Hey everybody, my name is Jennifer Hurley. This is Live at Binions Wednesday night. We host this podcast every Wednesday from 8:30 to 9:30. We create a listening room for local talented artists so that we can share them with the nation and the world, really. So, because, you know, YouTube is everywhere. Apparently it's on space shuttles and space, so we're interstellar, so. But we just want to share this with you. The event is actually from 8 to 11. So after this podcast, stick around. There'll be more music afterward. Binions is located in downtown Arlington at 205 Northwest Street. Come out, say hi to Amber, get yourself a drink, get yourself some tasty chicken fried steak. Thank you.
Or broccoli.
Or broccoli.
If that's what you're into.
Yeah, all broccoli and mashed potatoes. Chicken, yeah.
Hey,
Okay.
I know how you work things.
Like that, baby.
Thank you for Daniel Katsük for having me out here tonight. This is really cool.
Charles Gaby.
Awesome. This is posted both of y'all on Facebook, so that's pretty cool. Gonna be doing some of my original stuff tonight. I wrote a bunch of original stuff with a couple of rock bands, one called Ed Neuron, one called The Cosmic Trigger. Like they said, I play guitar in all fog, yes, but this is kind of a new thing for me to kind of get out here and do some of this stuff. We're going to go on kind of a journey and just kind of show you where I've come. This one, a lot of good stuff comes from a dark place, and a lot of my singer-songwriter stuff, not the heavy metal rocking stuff, kind of came from dark places at first. This one's called Broken Poet Blues.
Yeah.
Thank you all very much. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Would you try putting this feedback on the guitar?
Yes.
Or does it come from the string?
Yeah, the mic. I can move that mic.
That might be it. How's the bird? Do you want more?
Oh, great.
Feels good?
Okay. The bill all right up there?
You sound great, my friend. I'm actually going to turn your vocal off, just so. Let's see.
So most of what I'm going to play tonight is my originals, but this one's a cover song. Cover means that I'm covering it. I didn't write the song. So. Song came out about 10 years before I was born, but I really like it anyway. And that's my goal is to write songs like this. This is off the Led Zeppelin 4 album. Plays guitar, cries, and sings. La 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 la. Ride a white mare on the footsteps of dawn. Try to find a woman who's never, never been born. Standing on my hill in a mountain of dreams. Telling myself it's not hard, hard, hard as it seems. Yeah. Yeah, these guys are really nice. Thank you. Huh?
What's that tuning?
A double drop D. So your two E's, both of them go down to the D.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay.
A lot of new young songs are that way too. Like Cinnamon Girl. And Ohio. Probably still finished with you. All right. So my dad was a country singer, so he played a lot of stuff before I did, and he wrote a lot of stuff, so I got to see him like writing songs and how frustrating it was, and where I've got a band and then I can write riffs and stuff, and it's pretty easy. The lyrics kind of come after the riffs or the movement of music that you make, but there's a special thing about being able to play a few chords and put something that means something together with them, and I'm just not good at it, at least not yet, but... every now and then I do something and I think, man, this is pretty good, and that's what this is. So the story behind this song is the night that I wrote it was the first night that I heard that song, Empty Glass, by Gary Stewart. So that's a, I'm sure everybody's heard that. It's that empty glass, last cigarette. It's like, no, it's a cool song. And I probably heard it before. I guarantee I had, I just didn't listen to it. But I used to hang out at bars, and I just didn't want to go home. I was real depressed, and I was drunk. I didn't want to go home. I just wanted to drink. And I'd do anything to stay. Like, I would take out the trash and wipe off tables, all that stuff, just to get a few more drinks and not have to go home and be alone. I wasn't trying to pick up the bartender. I really just didn't want to go home. And I remember the song came on the radio, that Empty Glass song. I just sat there listening to it and just started crying, like, and I didn't want anybody to see me crying, but like the lyrics, it was like that guy wrote that song for me. And that's I went home that night and I wrote this song. So this is kind of inspired by that song, I guess you could say. I'm trying to write a country song, but you could try to imagine a band that sounds like Gary Stewart's band playing the song. That's kind of the idea I had behind it. Low, low, did she really say it was last call? Ain't there time for one more whiskey and beer? I just put another dollar in the jukebox. What do you mean I ain't gotta go home, but I can't stay here? Don't make me go home. I'll lie there all alone, thinking about how she's holding him tonight. My life is a Gary Stewart song. Hey bartender, can I help you wipe off the table? Pretty good at stacking chairs. If you'd like, maybe I could take the trash out. But I'm begging you, don't kick me out of here. Don't make me go home. My life is a Gary Stewart song. This one's a style that I'm trying to start playing in too. This is another, this is the last cover song I'm gonna do. It's one I just don't hear enough people do. It's probably my favorite song ever written. It's a... This is a Fleetwood Mac song, but everybody talks about the stuff that Stevie Nicks wrote when they went to the breakup, her and Lindsey Buckingham. There's a song on Rumors. It was one of the last songs written for Rumors. And it was Lindsey Buckingham trying to move on. So he had got a new girlfriend. But that's hard, you know, to, you know, move from Stevie Nicks to somebody. So nobody ever looks at his side of it. Like, man, that had to have been hard, you know. And so he wrote this song, I guess, about even though he loves Stevie Nicks and stuff, he just wasn't going to. Whatever was happening with them didn't go very good, so he put this song out there as kind of his answer to some of the songs she was writing bashing him. And he's like, well, I got a pretty good one, but he didn't really bash her. He just talks about he's going to move on and try to live his life, even though he's playing in the same band as the girl he just broke up with, or broke up with him, or however that worked. The song's called Never Going Back. It's gonna be my last song. We're gonna let Katsük get back up here and play some awesome songs with Charles and Gaby, and we're gonna all have a good night tonight. I can't thank him enough for inviting me out here. I was really, really surprised that he invited me, because I don't feel like I'm a very good songwriter, but it really made me feel good when he did, so.
We love every part of you, man.
I've been watching that guy since the record days at the humming acoustical nights and all that, and then I got in with the Kakuza brothers, and then it was just kind of, we became kind of friends, and it was like, man, this is kind of a dream come true. I've always really liked the stuff, man, for real. I brag on him, and he's one of the bright parts about this musical scene we got here in beautiful Fort Worth, Arlington, Texas.
Brag about you too, man. You're one of the best guitar players in 45 million planets.
I'm the best in Lithuaniastan or whatever. Alright, so here's a happy song I wrote. Those are kind of harder to write because it's like a whole different thing. You have to be open with your feelings and stuff. It's kind of easy to write when somebody hurts you or when you're going through bad stuff. But when you're going through happy stuff, it's like, man, you don't have the urge to write as much. I don't anyway. Maybe I should. So my high school sweetheart, even before that, junior high, there was a girl named Miranda that lived in Granbury, Texas, and me and her, she was the first girl I kissed anything, and you always remember your first love. Things just happened. I wanted to do music, she wanted kids and a husband and all that, and it just didn't work out at the time, so I moved to Fort Worth, she stayed in Granbury, she got married, she had kids, I did a bunch of bands and music, and everything gets darkest before the best light that happens, and the girl I was dating, everything was going great, and then just one day, she chose to take a handgun and end her life, and so I went down this deep, dark hole, and my whole world went to shit, and then at my lowest point, I get this call from her, and her husband had drank himself to death, and it was like, whoa, and we just started hanging out, not trying to hook up or anything, we just kind of had this, you know, just old friends just trying to be there for each other, not knowing how to play the rules of, you know, the world, and this horrible crap can happen, and you just need friends there. And as fate would have it, we just ended up still being in love and through all the stuff, and all those feelings came back, and she's always been my best friend, even when she was, you know, with him and I was doing my thing. We'd always call and just check on each other, but when the time came, it just everything felt right and it worked out, and now I'm the happiest I've ever been in my whole life. So I'm living down in Granbury with him, and I wrote this song about her. So it's the song's called "Colored My Gray Nights," but her name is Carol Miranda Gill Nichols. So CMGN, see, it's like both, you know, "Colored My Gray Nights," Carol Miranda Gill Nichols. So that's kind of why it's called that. Anyway, here's a song. This will be my last song. Thank you so much, Daniel, for having me. Thank you guys for listening. I've loved being here. This is awesome. Same sea, lost adrift, floating there. just can't swim no more. My heart will guide us to the shore, and I'll be yours forevermore. Thank you guys. You guys are awesome. Thank you very much. Tyrel Choat. Thank you.
And so all the tips that come in tonight are all going to our featured artist. So please take care of him and tip him and get his card, his information. Find out where Mr. Tyrel Choat is playing next with Alfuguez or any of his other projects. I know he plays with our brother Andy Weaver a lot. Man, I really liked your stories too behind everything. No, why am I sitting down? Thank you all for being here. This song's called Before You Shoot. And my cousin lives in Allen, Texas. And I think this is yours as well, man.
You left your underwear up here, too.
I mean,
good God.
I'll
man.
Do
what
that
what
for
else
you.
Is
going to
leave up here?
Left it all on the stage.
And yeah, my cousin lives in Allen, Texas. And she goes to this outlet mall all the time, and luckily she wasn't there last week. So this is for all the people up there in Allen who are dealing with this, and all of us who have to deal with the idea that we just never know who the fuck we're dealing with anymore. So this song's called Before You Shoot. To see it through your eyes, but all I saw were villains. And who you rolled to smoking gun towards all relations. You painted on the bathroom mirror, eyes and tears a victim. You step in front and wear the mask accordingly. Bullets are decisions. Friend, I tried my best to honor your position. But the booze gave you self-imposed. It happened when you tore your dress. Another day still under fire. What is new? The blame is placed on me, woman. You own the shooter. Perfectly so unusual. such a mystery. Thank y'all. All right. Sean's gonna play one, and we're gonna get up and do a couple together.
So I'm gonna play a song that I wrote in. This is one of the first songs I wrote. It's like
in the penitentiary.
I want to say this is 1977. School sweetheart.
9 minutes. 9 minutes.
Cool. Ooh, security.
So Daniel and I are going to do it's a song that we wrote for Monks of Symbiosis. And we've never tried to do it as a duo.
I don't play guitar on this one, so I just learned it last week and then we didn't play it. So we'll see what happens.
Thank you. between the madness and the tame, between the wild and the sane. It's a fine line, between the testing of the edge and the slipping off the ledge. It's a fine line, what you mean and what you make, what you feel and what you fake. It's a fine line, the testing of tripping up the ledge. I gotta give to Daniel, he just learned that guitar part for last week and we didn't do it. And then he hasn't rehearsed it. In the meantime.
It was in there somewhere.
Oh yeah.
We're gonna do one more and say goodbye to our friends online and thank y'all so much for hanging out with us. And Jennifer for putting this together and Binions for having us and Tyrel Choat, y'all go check out his music, the Off of Jazz and all of his other stuff that he's doing. And then we're going to take just a quick break after that, and then we're going to play for y'all human beings who are actually here in the room being humans. Not saying that those are who are online or AI robots, but we're saying that just come out in the flesh, man. Come out and be around other people.
Yeah.
weather's been pretty crazy today. And it's messing with my guitar. Don't you know there's a